Good morning and welcome to the Spring of Grace. We continue with the series on the Ten Commandments, and today our focus is on the fourth. It says, remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you, nor your son or daughter, nor your manservant or maidservant, nor your animals, nor the alien within your gates. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them. But he rested on the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. Exodus chapter 20, verse 8 to 11. We actually see that it is God who instituted the Sabbath. What does it mean to us? Is it just about a day? And Jesus gave us an answer about that question. Jesus said, the Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath. So the Son of Man is the Lord even of the Sabbath. So we actually shift, there is a shift from just a day to the Sabbath being about a person, and that is Jesus Christ. So the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath. Again, Paul commented on the Sabbath in the book of Colossians, and this is what it says, Colossians chapter 2, verse 16 to 18. Therefore, do not let anyone judge you by what you eat or drink, or with regard to a religious festival or a new moon celebration or a Sabbath day. These are a shadow of the things that were to come. The reality, however, is found in Christ. With this in mind, how then can we apply the Sabbath, the commandment about the Sabbath in our lives today as believers? Three things. One, the principle of rest. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 9 to 10. The Bible says, there remains then a Sabbath, rest for the people of God, for anyone who enters God's rest also rests from his own work, just as God did from his. So rest, the principle of rest, not just from our daily work, but actually an eternal rest that begins when a person gives their lives to Jesus, and unto eternity. Principle number two is the principle of worship. And I read a scripture to explain that. Ezekiel chapter 46 verse 3. On the Sabbath and new moons, the people of the land are to worship in the presence of the Lord at the entrance to that gateway. Secondly, another scripture. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate to the river, where we expected to find a place of prayer. We sat down and began to speak to the women who had gathered there. So as we think about the Sabbath, let's know that we can apply the principle of worship, that on the Sabbath day, we worship the Lord. And thirdly, the principle of service to God. How much more valuable is a man than a sheep? Therefore, it is lawful to do good on the Sabbath. Matthew chapter 12, verse 12. Another scripture, my Father is always at his work to this very day, and I too am working. John chapter 5, verse 17 to 18. Jesus actually spoke these words on a Sabbath day. And so just as I said earlier, it is not about a day. It is a daily walk with the Lord, daily practicing rest, worship, and service to God. Have a blessed day.